everybody, and welcome to Teenage Q Stuff You Should Know. Today we are talking about family holiday survival, surviving the holidays with your family. Now, rule number one is for travel and for home, really, always have a book. Always bring a book with you. Maybe have a second in the car just in case. This is so that you can get out of any situation, really. You could be like, I need to go finish my book. I have one chapter left. You could also be like, I'm reading that for school, and that's very important. So you just sneak over in the corner and finish your book. Now, if you need to do a little bit more than that throughout the holiday season, there are some good ways to keep yourself entertained. For example, you could try a bingo sheet. We have an example of a Thanksgiving bingo, of a regular holiday party bingo. Some things that you could use on it are like out of gravy. I'm gonna put it up here so you can see. There's out of gravy. There's drunk grandma, which I think is fascinating. I can't read it upside down. Someone crying. You could maybe have ugly sweater or someone wears sequins. I always had a person in my family who wore sequins to every family holiday event that there was. Maybe everybody has hot cocoa. You could do something nice like that instead of mean stuff. You're having candy canes. You always have to make sure that you add your free space in. This is important as well. Now, there will be a link below to a blank bingo sheet if you'd like to add your own. Perhaps you have a weird aunt who is a nurse who always likes to talk about the weirdest diseases and wounds that she has seen. Or maybe you have an uncle who's on the fire department who always leaves in the middle of the dinner and his pager goes off and he takes off. Maybe you could put that on there. Maybe your brother's just annoys you all the time and you want something easy. You know he'll annoy you, so you can just put down annoying brother. Just a couple ideas to keep you going. There's also some fun road trip games you could try. We have things like fun facts. You could do the hot seat where everybody gets to interview one person in the car, which seems a little scary. There's always the ABC game with like looking at signs and license plates as you go along and following along. You could also do the eat the alphabet game, which I enjoy, where you are naming different kinds of foods that start with different letters. However, if you do that, make sure that you have brought snacks with you, because otherwise you're just gonna get super hungry before you get to the meal, and you don't wanna do that. Other things you should bring: headphones, very important. Deck of cards, keep grandma happy since you have run out of wine. Phone charger, a power bank. Make sure that you keep your electronics charged so that you're not super bored in the car ride on the way back. Always make sure you have a pillow and blanket, an extra outfit, just in case you were to end up stuck in a hotel or on the side of the road because your car broke down or there was bad snow, bad weather. You can also always make sure to bring a sweater with you because it gets cold in people's houses who don't like to turn their heat up very high. I'm one of those people who likes my heat on. Other people maybe only have it in the fireplace in the corner and you're like, eh, I'm cold. So make sure you bring your sweater. And make sure that you have two books with you, just in case. Again, rule number one. So a couple other ideas for you. Make a family playlist for the car ride. Could be fun. Sing some holiday songs. Put some oldies on there for your parents to enjoy. Make sure you include some Baby Shark for your little brother. I've just decided that you have a little brother. Who is annoying. Bonus points if you are able to find a holiday or an audiobook that everybody in your car will enjoy and listen to in the car ride, especially if it's holiday themed. Could be a lot of fun. And a few more tips just to get you out of some difficult situations that you might find yourself in during a holiday party. Maybe if you feel like someone is having a heated argument or a conversation that you don't want to be part of, good idea is to ask if anybody needs help in the kitchen or to set the table. Don't take the bait. That is a good one that I I really liked. Do you have that one relative that always wants a good argument? Good way to throw that off is don't engage. Be like, hey, you know what? I think my mom read a really cool book about that. She should send it to you. Have you read any good books lately? Totally change the subject, and you get to talk about books. Very important. You could also talk about other things that you have read, watched, or maybe a game, a video game that you like to play. Maybe you get everybody involved in Among Us, or everybody can play along with some Smash Bros, who knows? Or if all else fails, you can talk about the food and how tasty it is, because there's always something yummy at Thanksgiving. Preferably some macaroni and cheese, some mashed potatoes. I think it's time for me to go eat my lunch. So I think that's all I have for you today. Stick around for some stuff you should know.
Miss Jessica, I just thought of one.
What's that?
What if you pick a word and you spend the whole day trying to get everybody at the party to say that word?
That is a great idea.
So it could be something holiday themed or just a word that you really like, but then you're having your own conversation that they don't realize you're having because you're trying to get them to say a particular word.
That would be a lot of fun.
It could be a fun game.
It would. I like it. All right. I think that's all we have for you today. Make sure you check out all of our other videos and check out our website, www.greenwoodlibrary.us. I'll talk to you later. Bye.